Let's see how can we recognize if a string is a hexa, octal or a binary number. So we start with this script that we used earlier that goes over lines of a file and checks each line against a regular expression that we'll have to put here and prints out the line if there is a match. And we also have a file that I already created which has some strings in it, so there is a number, let's see. Let's add a word here, just something, some letters. Then there is a hexadecimal number. This is a hexadecimal number that is not really correct because it uses G, so that's not really a correct hexadecimal. Then a binary, an incorrect binary, an octal, another octal, and an incorrect octal because there is the digit 8. So let's see how the script works. Let's try start with a hexadecimal number. So a hexadecimal number is at the beginning has a 0 and an X and it has digits in there. So afterwards we have use a character class because we have several types of characters. Digits, that's 0 to 9, then lowercase a till f and uppercase a till f. So these are the characters that we accept, and then we have to, and that's it. Let's try this one. So if I switch over to this screen and run the script with the given file, then it prints out the two hexas, or better to say the one that is correctly hexa and the other one which is incorrectly hexa, because it's not, so this part is hexa and this is not included in there, and that's exactly what happens, and that's the reason it matches, because we just said that from the beginning. So if you look at the regular expression, we said that from the beginning this character says, and then what we have, and we didn't say that till the end, so it just matched the beginning of the string and it didn't left out the G, but the line contains it. So if you want to make sure that the whole string is really a is checked, then we have to put from the beginning till the end checking. If we switch over to the window again and then run the script now, you can see that it only matches the one that is really a hexadecimal number. Then we wanted to have octal numbers, so the octal numbers would just start with a leading a 0 and then have numbers from 0 till 7. And we can have one or more of these. And if you run this, that we get, that's what we get. So we get the octal numbers, but we haven't seen the octal number that has additional a digit that's too high. And finally, we wanted to have the binary numbers. So they start with a 0, then a B, and then zeros and ones, again one or more of them, and that's it. If you run it, it will show the one that it's really a binary number and won't show the rest of it, not even the one that looks like a binary but has a number 2 in it.